Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of First Fireups. I am Scorch82, and I am joining you from Duckburg today. We are going to be playing DuckTales Remastered on this episode of First Fireups, the show where I play a game for the very first time and let you know if it's worth your time by the end. This is a remake of probably one of the best well-known Capcom NES games, DuckTales, released for the NES in 1989. And anybody who grew up with a Nintendo likely had this game in their library, or at least knows it well enough to say they liked it or completely hated it. I, being a child of the 80s and 90s, really love this cartoon, and I really love the game as well, so I'm really looking forward to playing this one for you today. This was remade by WayForward Productions, and published by Capcom, of course, so their name being on that hopefully means it's going to be pretty good. Because this is a remade NES title, there's not really a whole lot of controller configuring to do, because it was meant to be played with an NES controller back in the day. Capcom also remade a couple of other games from their past classics, like Bionic Commando. They made Bionic Commando Rearmed. That one didn't add a whole lot of complexity to the mix when they came up with that remake, so they're very well known for remaking retro titles and doing quite well. Mega Man 9 and 10 are also prime examples of that, so I'm really looking forward to this. So let's just jump right into a new game. We're going to play on medium, because that's what we do. It's the money bin.
Cuss me, kilts. Me money bin alarm. Quick, Duckworth, get the limo.
I shall get her in gear, sir.
Hurry, Duckworth, hurry!
The pedal is to the metal, Mr. McDuck.
Ugh, not the Beagle Boys again. If they think they can stand between Scrooge McDuck and his 3 cubic acres of cash, they've got another thing coming.
Oh my. Looks like we got ourselves an intro stage here, so it's platforming at its best. It kind of sounded like those are the original voices from the cartoon, and I don't remember if reading about some of this I actually heard that that was the case or not. So anybody who is not familiar with DuckTales on the NES, the premise is simple. It's platforming side by side. Scrooge McDuck is armed with a cane that he can use to pogo on top of enemies' heads, and that's how he fights enemies. He can also, when he's standing against something, bash it. If it can move, it'll move. If not, he'll make that funny little whack sound.
Uncle Scrooge! Uncle Scrooge up here!
Oh, Huey! Are you all right, my boy?
Yeah, but you better watch out! The Beagle Boys messed with your security system!
Ooh, yeah! We take over the whole place.
Yeah, me money.
Hey, don't forget about me, Uncle Scrooge.
Eh? Oh, don't worry, lad. I'll save you.
While jumping, hold X to perform the pogo jump.
Mom would be so proud. I caught me a duck.
Doink.
Now that's what I call a stomach ache.
You were hit on the head, you moronic marauder.
Scrooge!
You're welcome, lad. But Huey, what are you doing here?
Well, we saw the Beagle Boys going into the money bin.
We?
Sure. Louie and Dewey are here, too. You better hurry, Uncle Scrooge. They might be in trouble.
Yeah. So, you jump around and you can find hidden gems. The object is to get as much of your money as possible and finish the game with a high score. Boink. Alright, climbing ropes. Good stuff.
Look at that luster. Treasure.
Yeah. Since there wasn't much of an options menu, I didn't really spend time showing it. That's what I tend to do when I play games like this, or in this series, so that people can see what kind of options they're going to be able to configure their game with. So the ice cream is one heart refill if you happen to take a hit. Being a fan of the original game, I'm very much aware that there's lots of hidden gems, so that's why I'm kind of like poking around. And I believe you don't want to, like, because those start to disappear, you kind of have to pick and choose what things you go after. The red diamonds that we just picked up in those boxes, I believe, are worth 50,000. The large ones are 10,000, and the other ones are 1,000 or 5,000. I don't remember. Suppose we'll find out. Yeah, so those are 10,000.
Hey, kid, you got a sandwich or something?
Oh, I remember Burger Beagle.
Not even for an afternoon snack. Big time in trouble, me.
Get away from him, you gluttonous goon.
Sorry, Scroogey. Not a chance.
So the one thing that I've noticed so far is that, It's like Smash Brothers. One thing I've noticed so far is the,
You saved me, Uncle Scrooge!
I did. I hurt a lot.
Now, I'm fine, but I saw Louie heading up the stairs with about 1,000 Beagle Boys right behind him.
Stay here. I'll handle this.
It's that campy 90s cartoon humor. The rock goes up in a diagonal motion. The game starts up on a resolution that, I can't get that one now. Shit. It starts up in a resolution that's tied to my secondary monitor for some reason. And it starts up on my secondary monitor, and I can't figure out how to get it onto the primary one without, actually disabling it within Windows. That's kind of shitty that a game like that can't be fixed, like, easily. Yeah, so those are 2,000. I believe you can get small red ones, too. There we go. Stuff like this is just screaming for treasure. And the automatic screen scrolling wasn't something that was in the NES version either, so those diamonds would have fallen off screen if they were even possible to get from up there. And one thing that also the NES game was very notorious for is being able to go above the screen to find things. So I imagine that that's going to be a recurring theme as well. Or whatever the updated equivalent would be in today's technology. You got a good old life count there. I'm probably not going to be able to get this now because I shouldn't have moved that. Yep, you can get yourself screwed out of being able to get certain treasures because of how you choose to handle things. Get that one. Oh, it got me. I gotta find an ice cream cone now.
Hurry up, Uncle Scrooge! They're headed for your office!
Oh, no!
Hold on, lad. I'll have you free in a jiffy.
Not so fast, McDuck. We're running things around here now.
Cuss me, Kilt. One false move and I'm a roast duck.
Leave me, Uncle Scrooge. It's not worth it.
Nonsense, McDuck.
Lies. All right, we got to get through this laser.
Hey, when I get the gold, I'm gonna find Mom.
Got him.
Ow.
Traps are crazy, man. Traps are crazy.
Woo-hoo! We almost got them all.
A fat lot of good that will do us if they make it to me vault.
Yeah, but they got the security system, so that's not really gonna help now, is it? Oh, fuck. I took a hit. I need me some ice cream or a cake, maybe. Cake is supposed to refill your health, I believe. There's the cake. There we go. I got 500,000 already just in the hallways.
Step away from me fortune, you crook.
Not this time, McDuck. You ain't getting the drop on this beagle boy.
Not this time. Oh, the boss music.
I'm gonna get you.
Oh, shit. Boink.
That's smart.
Oh, no, you don't.
I think I'll bust him with this.
Oh, he got me. I'm gonna have to watch for patterns.
You're safe. You're securely suspended, son.
Boink. How does that not kill him? Duck.
There you are, sir.
That's the standard boss music.
Oh, no.
Oh, he got me.
Oh, dear. Do be careful or you'll scuff the floor.
Oh, no. Fuck. I get my ass handed to me. It's hard to tell what he's gonna do. I don't like this. He's gotta jump.
There you are, sir.
Bounce on his head. Always, that's how you kill a boss.
Everything's ready, sir.
Doink. Work smarter, not harder.
Curse you, mutt duck! This ain't the last you'll see of me!
Eh, good riddance to bad beagles, I say. Now, why in the world was he interested in this old painting? Surely there are more valuable... Well, pluck me pin feathers. It looks like some kind of secret code. Boys!
What did you find, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, what is it?
I'm not sure, but I know how to find it out. I'll feed it into my supercomputer and use Gyro's new crypto analysis program. Then we'll know what the Beagle Boys were after. Stand back, lads. Brigadoon!
What is it, Uncle Scrooge?
It's a treasure map, lads. And no ordinary treasure by the look of things.
Only Uncle Scrooge would call any kind of treasure ordinary. Look, one of the treasures is in the middle of the Amazon. And there's another one in Transylvania. And one buried 10 miles underground. Hey, wait a minute. Something's screwy. This last treasure can't be right. Yeah, there's no mountain on Earth that's that high. Well, according to the Junior Woodchuck's guidebook, to get there we'd have to take about 537 million steps straight up till we reach the moon. You mean the moon?
It looks that way, lads. Well, what are we waiting for? That treasure's no going to discover itself.
Oh, so this is how they got to the little treasure machine in the beginning of the first DuckTales. So they had the stage select. You can pick one of five stages. The Amazon, the Transylvania, African Mines, the Himalayas, and the Moon, with the infamous Moon theme that I'm hoping has an awesome remastered score. I'll probably play them in order. There's no rhyme or reason to the order, at least as far as I can tell. So let's start with the Amazon. Do we want to travel the Amazon? Of course we do!
Get Launchpad on the horn. I'm headed to the Amazon jungle to find the scepter of the Incan King.
Launchpad McQuack. There's that signature helicopter with the rope hanging on it. Oh, Gyro, gear loose. Being able to do this little bonus stage had something to do with... Oh, fuck. I didn't see the cloud there that was blocking me. It's kind of annoying. It had something to do with finishing the stage or leaving the stage when you had like a 7 in the 10,000th place.
Thanks for the lift, Launchpad.
No problemo. Lift is one of my favorite principles of aerodynamics. Oh, say, you got your radio, Mr. McD?
Of course I do.
Great. Then I'll be your eyes in the sky.
Look, I'd be happy if you just keep your eyes on the sky for once.
Hmm.
What an airhead.
Hey, I heard that.
Now then, ancient Incan legends claim the king's scepter was locked away in a giant temple of the clouds, and it should be dead ahead.
Gee, Mr. McGee, I see a lot of clouds, but no temple.
You wouldn't, Launchpad. The legend says the temple was hidden away from all but King Manco Capquack himself. But there's bound to be a way to reveal it buried somewhere in this overgrown salad bowl. And I'm not leaving till I find it.
Hmm. Nice treasure in the ruins that are so nicely laid out for us. Oh, yeah. You can bring up the map. Oh, there's a map. There was no map in the other game. And here's the options available right here for us. Look at that. That's crazy. Inventory and everything. That sucks. I wanted that rock. Or that treasure box. We're going to have to use an enemy to go get it. Do 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 do. The big treasure box.
Launchpad, I found an ancient coin depicting a nightingale.
Edo, you haven't stumbled across a pizza joint down there, have you, Mr. McDee? I'm getting kind of hungry up here.
I'm not even going to dignify that question with a response.
Yeah.
1 billion 1. 1 billion 2.
The gorillas will jump. And these things, you can't jump on them because they'll eat you. Those are bad, okay? Oh yeah, the invincibility coin. These are awesome. And the bees. I hate the bees. We're going up here. There's secrets up here.
I've never seen a gem like this. Another coin. And this one has an inscription of an eagle.
And I'm glad they don't make the unskippable dialogue. Oh, the inventory is those coins. I guess I gotta find those all on every level. They don't make that penalize you for not picking up a collectible during that time. I probably should not have gone that way. But now I'm not gonna be able to get back up there without taking a hit. Oh, I got it. I got it! And there's gonna be a gorilla, probably. Let's jump down and see what's down here. In the caves.
I knew it.
Look, a stack of boxes. Something under the stairs, of course. There we go.
Aha! A coin bearing the image of the Queen's horse. Ha! It'll help us find the treasure for sure.
Nice.
Never doubt the well-honed instincts of an experienced treasure hunter.
If you say so, Mr. McDee.
Yeah, Launchpad, just have faith, bro. So the map will tell us if we've got treasures to find. So those are those coins, I'm guessing. I guess it's a little easy to find them when the map tells you where they all are, but... Spider! These spiders scared the shit out of me as a kid. Gotta time it so you can, fuck it. So you can bounce on them. Fuck. There we go.
A coin showing the sun. Gads, I nearly tripped over it. This place is a mess. Where's Mrs. Beakley when you need her?
This place is gross. You gotta clean up after yourself, guy. Oh fuck, I'm gonna die down here. I wanna kill that spider. There we go. Fuck your spider ass. I mean, fudge your spider butt. Got him. I'm gonna have to re-get used to that whole, there's a coin or something up there. Have to get used to that whole letting go of the button so that you don't pogo so far up. Dick. Fire 2! Fire 7! So the difficulty on the NES title was always a
coin with the image of a scythe. It must represent a good harvest.
Or the Reaper.
This is Launchpad, calling Mr. McDee.
What is it, Launchpad?
I'm running a little low on fuel up here.
Well, where are the extra fuel canisters?
That's why I'm calling you, boss. I checked the glove compartment, but all I found was gloves.
Oh, you'd best find those fuel canisters, or the next thing you'll be flying is a model airplane.
Okay, okay. Last time I ask you for help.
Is that a promise?
Gee, thanks, bro. Yeah, the NES version sported two difficulties. I think it was like medium or easy and difficult. And, that one...
Found another one, and it depicts the ruling might of a spear.
I kind of don't like how it stops me every time for that.
Come in, Mr. Flick!
Launchpad, what was that?
Nothing, boss. I'm sure nobody was using that tree anyway. Except maybe them. And them.
Irritating.
Fire one.
Dunk. Whoa. I need cake. Give me cake. The two difficulty levels were such that you could take two hits per heart, or you could take one hit per heart, and that was the difficult setting. I don't remember there being a specific reward for finishing a game on either of them. It was just however much time you wanted to spend screwing around with whatever they were.
Look at this one. It shows a shield. You know, I bet those Incans could have minted a whole lot more coins if they hadn't tried to make each one unique.
Mm-hmm. That's one way to think about it. Bees. I hate bees. Oh, he got me!
Ow, ow, ow!
And I took a hit, so that's kind of lame, but whatever. And he's too stupid, so he's stuck there. Ugh, wavy patterns. I hate it. Go, go, go! Yay, ice cream!
Aha! This coin bears an image of the scales of justice. Just what I need to help me find the scepter.
You know, Mr. McDee, I had a thought.
Launchpad, why start now and spoil a perfect record?
That's a good question.
Well, I don't have all day. What was your thought?
Come to think of it, I forgot.
Launchpad, were you dropped on your head much as a child?
All the time. Why?
I see what he did there. Alright, let's check our map. Ah, got me again! Stupid asshole plants.
Come in, Launchpad. I found something. There's a carving of Manco Capquack on this stone slab, and there's 8 circular notches around it.
Sounds great! Does it tell us how to find the treasure?
Well, I'm not sure what it tells us, but I'm certain it's an important clue. Bless me, bagpipes. These coins I found will fit perfectly into those notches.
Oh, you must have come across an ancient Incan poker table, Mr. McDee. How about I come down there and you deal me in for a hand?
You come down here and I'll deal you a blow to the head. You're supposed to be keeping an eye out for trouble, remember? Launchpad, what if the images on these coins symbolize the various tribes of Manco Capquack's empire? Maybe if I surround him with them.
Yeah, throw them all in there.
No, it's not working.
Hey, maybe you need to say the magic words. Or maybe not.
So this is where that temple came from.
you look at that? The ancient city of Manco Capquack. And that beam of light, it must be pointing to the Temple of the Clouds. But how am I going to get across?
Up here, Mr. McD.
Oh, so that's why he's flying around.
Follow that beam of light.
Oh, not the bees. Oh, God. I'm not sure what to make of all this. I don't want that. Not enough. I want that one, though. Thanks for flying me across, buddy.
Whoa! I did it! I found the legendary temple of Manco Capquack.
With a little help from your old pal, Launchpad McQuack.
Oh, of course, Launchpad. I couldn't have done it without you. Now just hold on, and with a little luck, that scepter will be mine in no time.
Trying to skip this stupid dialogue, just to save time for the video. I found 50 grand. Alright, and this is where you emerge in the original version. I kind of want to play the original version now, just to compare. That's where you emerge after you cross that bridge that collapses, but in the other game, you went the other way. You didn't go left to right, you went right to left. And a secret.
This old duck still got it.
Now let's see, there's a well-known secret, or maybe a not-so-well-known secret, to get past this next upcoming area in the original version to avoid having to pay a fee. I wonder if they left that intact. Had something to do with this set of blocks there.
Gatwick coming through.
Oh no! It's right there. But I didn't know that box was gonna show up. Fucking goddamn it. I'm gonna end up taking a hit. Oh, there's another one. There we go. Climb on up. I need life, or I'm going to die.
Yippee!
We need to do the level where you can get some increased health. Hello, Mrs. Beakley. Feed me.
Why are you here, Mrs. Beakley?
I'm just making sure you stick to your diet, Mr. McDuck.
Yes.
You're worth your weight in gold, Mrs. Beakley. If you'll pardon the expression.
Huh, of course. But I'll find my own way out, thank you very much.
I'm not sure how I feel about their lips not moving when they speak. Got a healthy appetite. Got an extra life. It's a mojo doll. And I got a cake. And ice cream. Oh, yeah. Let's do this. Oh, it was this idol right here. You had to pay to get into this rope. But they skipped that. And instead replaced the secret with Mrs. Beakley and her one-up giving things. That's neat. I guess it pays to know some stuff about the past. Oh shit. Forgot about this because I never take this route. Oh, fuck. Man, difficult. Can't collect it in midair. That blows. Kill him! Aw. Hit my head quite a bit. Put your head down, bruh. Kind of shitty that you can't swing your cane when you're not against something, so you can't use it to hit those guys. How high are we going? The boss is up there. I don't trust this asshole. Fall down. Fall to your death. There's an ice cream cone, which I have to collect now or it won't be useful later. Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck! Kill him! I don't want to die here, because... Well, you know. Let's get this one first. Yeah! Three lives. Up I go. Going to the boss chamber. Gotta get the last bit of treasure. Alright. Refill. There it is.
There it is, the King's Scepter. Well, oh, this was easier to find than a penny in a parking lot. Catch me, kilts! What was that?
Oh no, this is where we had to fight the- Oh, the idol, he got me! This is gonna be a lot harder, I guarantee. The room is a lot smaller, that's for damn sure. Get him, get him, get him! As long as nothing falls on my head. Oh god. Oh lord. It's more involved than it was before. It's scary. Get him, get him, get him! Get him! Oh god! Oh man. The thing. The earthquakes help keep you from, pogoing, which is bad. Watch the ones that shake. And then you won't get hurt. Die. Oh, that hurts me. That sucks. No! Oh, you bitch. Gotta take more hits. Yippee. Or get more hits, I should say. He never took this many hits back in the old version, so... A lot of this is gonna be really hard for me just because of what I remember from the old game. Not being what I expect it to be. Which kind of sucks, but whatever. Oh, God. I want you to die already. Hole. One more. Oh god, don't duck. The shitty directional pad kinda doesn't really work out too well either. No! Ugh, fuck. Almost took a hit there. Oh god! Almost fucked up there. Nope, fuck you. Not gonna get me this time. Ha ha! F you! Oh no! I wasn't looking. I didn't see the one on the left. Not gonna get me this time. Not gonna happen, sir. Go! Things are faster, he's starting to die. Boom. He's starting to break. Starting to break. There, he broke. He died. I died twice. Wow, that was tough. Tougher than it looks. Or maybe I just suck. I don't know.
This place has fallen to pieces.
No, I'm not leaving without that scepter. Get us out of here, Launchpad! I cannot believe we came all this way for nothing! What's the meaning of this?
Outsider, our prophecies have long foretold that our ancient city would one day be returned to us. For hundreds of years we have waited, and at last that day has come.
You mean you're not mad at me?
Mad? Quite the contrary, Feathered One. Is there anything we can do to repay you?
Well, now that you mention it, I did come here looking for an ancient scepter. I didn't suppose...
Does it look like this? It fell from the temple.
Oh, they're climbing for nothing. Hey, Mr. McD?
Bless me, bagpipes, the scepter of the Incan King!
It is yours. Take it and go in peace. After all, it was just the old king's back scratcher.
Yeah, get that nice victory music at the end of the stage. Hell yeah. Got a million for each treasure. More money for playing on a higher difficulty. 2.5 million for that. I only died
the
twice.
The scepter of the Incan King. I tell you, boys, there's something special about this treasure.
Really, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, it just looks like an old back scratcher to us.
You boys need to learn some respect for the finer things in life. Now, if you're done having fun at your old uncle's expense, help me decide where we should go next.
Extravagant housewares. Alright, what's this? Just like looking at my pile of money.
Ugh, my arms are getting tired.
Nice. Now that's pulling Scrooge McDuck and swinging through the money, which in reality would make you probably break your neck. I imagine this thing will start to fill up as we complete stages. That's cool. It's a nice little feature there. Where should we go next? So, the health upgrades are in the Himalayas and Transylvania. So let's go to the Himalayas. We'll see if this one is... It's kind of a tough stage, but it should be okay.
Pack my parka, Duckworth. We're headed for the Himalayas to hunt for the lost crown of Genghis Khan.
Shall I forward your call, sir?
Gee, can I come, Uncle Scrooge? I want to see the pretty Himalayan marmots.
Oh, not this time, Wibby, darling. I need you here looking after the boys. Otherwise, who knows what kind of trouble they might get into.
Oh, that's very smart.
Uncle Scrooge!
Indulge me, lads. The last thing this expedition needs is a wee lass about. Ugh, I'm going to have enough trouble looking after the launch pad.
Yeah, screw that guy. Yeah, looks like we get our opportunity for a bonus. Every time. Alright, let's not fuck up and not hit the cloud this time, because I can kind of not tell where they are. I think you had the opportunity to get like 100,000 or something in this little stage. And this was like what you wanted to do if you wanted to increase your scores. You would leave the level with Launchpad with the sevens digit as a seven, I think.
Launchpad, I told you to land in the center of the mountain range, not in the center of a mountain.
Gee, Mr. McDee, I thought that crash was rock solid.
The only rocks around here are the ones inside your head. Ugh, we're nowhere near Shadow Pass and the Lost Crown. Now fix this wreck so we can get airborne. And step on it, lad. I'm paying you by the hour, and I'll nae having you billing me for overtime.
No problem, boss. As long as I have this fuel regulator, we're as good as... Whoopsie-daisy. Oops. My mom always said I was a Butterfingers.
Oh, no. Please tell me you've got another one of those.
Sure I do, but it's back in Duckburg.
Launchpad!
Don't worry, Mr. McDee. I'll climb down and get it.
You'll do no such thing. I'll get it. You stay here and try not to cause any more damage.
Okay, you're the boss.
Yeah. Stupid idiot. Oh, no. Do, 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 do. Yeah, we have to hit the bunny rabbits that travel in the snow. And if you pogo in the snow, you get stuck. So you can't do that. Can't pogo in the snow. Oh, bouncy goats! Oh no. One got me. Oh god. Goddamn mountain goats. I hate when enemies respawn. It's so irritating. Let's go down here. I believe going down is where we get the health upgrade. We are going down into the mountain. And there will be no going back. There's the fuel regulator. Jackpot. Fell right into the cave.
Here now.
No!
Don't touch that. I need it to fix my plane. Stop!
Oh, shit.
Oh, it's too late. Those bunny bandits have torn it apart. I've got to find those pieces fast.
Yeah, so there's the obligatory find the items. So this was kind of a nice addition to get people to explore the entire set of levels.
The secret passage.
There's the health upgrade, which is not where it was in the original version. I'm gonna be making lots of comparisons. Sorry if you don't like that. But yeah, like you could skip a bunch of the level and never ever look at it all. Oh, fuck. Because you weren't forced to find any of that shit. And now we sort of are, so I guess that's kind of good. Oh, hockey-playing asshole duck. And the ice you can, like, slip on, so we don't want that. And these are spikes. Fuck! You always gets me before I get him. This is bullshit. Yoink.
Morning and glory. Now to find the other two pieces.
Oh, man. Can I go up here? Yes, I can. What did I just find? I don't know what the hell's up here, but... Whoa! How'd you do that? Spin around like that. Come on. Wow! And I swear to God, I hope you can't get hit by the hockey stick. Get him! We gotta go down. Me first! I'm better than you. So far, the hit detection seems fairly fair. But it's hard when the enemies go in front of your character sprite, so you can't really see where you're standing. Get it! Gotta go up and around. Oh man.
Oh, no, you don't.
Got it. I win. Almost fucked that up. Okay, that makes me fall down. Don't want to do that. This is the way to the boss. Made it. Fuel can.
This old duck still got it.
Yeah, I found all that treasure. Hell yes, I did. Must have to go down below. I don't like it at all. 2-1. Oh, that guy didn't die. Well, that sucks. I'll get it. Go. Gotta get out of the way.
Will wonders never cease? Launchpad, that crate looks almost airworthy.
Don't crack up what you can't fix up, I always say. Any luck finding that fuel regulator?
Ugh, no. Some wee beasties ran off with it in pieces. They've got to be down there somewhere.
All right, but I'm gonna need it before I can finish any more repairs.
Is there not something else to keep you busy while you wait?
Nope.
Good. Enjoy the downtime, then.
Gee, thanks, boss.
Because I'm docking your pay till I get back.
Gee, thanks.
Wow, what a nice guy. Whoa. That's what gets me. See? And over-anticipating. I hate enemies that can jump. There's just something about jumping enemies. Especially ones that can change their path. Whoa. Fucking shit. Alright, now where to? Let's go this way. I'm a scared. Life. I want life. Yeah, life. Diamonds!
Once an adventurer, always an adventurer.
Holla. Go, go, go. Before that goat flies down and gets you. That hurt. Cake! Cake if you need life! Alright, one of these rabbits down here has to have my piece. It says they're quite far away, though. It doesn't look like there's a boss in this one, unless you just do this stupid portion and then he flies you to the boss. That could be what it is. Let's go down here. Whoa. That looks like a hole. I'm not going that way. You can barely see the platform. Oh, fuck. I was gonna fall in the pit there. That would have sucked balls. There's my piece.
It's the second piece of the fuel regulator. One more piece to find and we can get out of this overgrown icebox.
Give me credit for my invincibility. Or was that not what that was? It certainly looked like invincibility to me. Whoa! Kinda had a feeling that was gonna happen.
Waka-waka, it's a treasure!
This was where you were supposed to get the, This is where you're supposed to get the, extra health, I believe. Just in an area like this. Bonk. Let's see, where does this go? That goes up to the other thing, and I don't want to go that way. Yeah, it's Bubba! Gosh, Bubba was supposed to give you the health.
It's Bubba Duck! Looks like that poor little pea brain got caught in a deep freeze.
Bonk.
Whoa, what happened? Scooge? Ooga, ooga! Scooge saved Bubba!
There, there, little fella. Uncle Scrooge is here to help.
Scooge saved Bubba! Scooge saved Bubba! Scooge saved Bubba! Bubba helped Scooge! Bubba helped Scooge forever!
You know, I could use a bit of help smashing away this giant icebox. What do you say, Bubba?
Ooga, ooga!
In that case, follow me, lad!
Do it, bro, do it! Come on. Do I have to lead him through there, or how the fuck does that work? Kill that, there you go, kill that asshole guy. No! You retard! There it is. Get this one. Get this one. There you go. Get him! Get him! Let's go! You're not gonna fool me this time, stupid Bubba.
This is the end of the line, Bubba. It's time for you to head to the surface.
Bubba home with Scrooge?
Aye, launch pad is waiting to take you home to Duckburg. On your way now.
Oh man. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Nope, I need that $4,000. Should let me climb into that area with the other bunny. There he is. He's got sparklies.
Oh,
he's a special rabbit.
The last one. Now to get this fuel regulator back to launch pad.
Now I gotta go back. Hopefully there's a shortcut. Ah. I like secrets. Give me some health. There we go. And there's where that hole goes. Now we're going back up. let's not take a hit this time. See you later, bunny rabbit. I gotta climb this rope that's just hanging in the middle here. I guess the sparkles are just the snow. I thought it was because he was special. No, he's not special. He's just a part-stealing bunny rabbit. Boom! Alright, here we are. There's Bubba. Come on, Bubba.
Here you go, Launchpad. Good as new. Now get this bucket of bolts back in the sky.
Just a tick, Mr. McD. This oughta do it. Now there's your problem.
Webbergail, what in the world are you doing here?
I wanted to see the pretty crown, Uncle Scrooge.
Oh, great. Now I've got to babysit you and Launchpad.
But I can help, Uncle Scrooge. You're not like the boys, are you? You don't think I'm just a worthless tag-along, do you?
We're ready for liftoff, Mr. McD.
Ah, not a moment too soon. Strap in tight, Webby dear.
There we go.
Off we go. Nothing but blue skies ahead. Clear as a bell. Not a cloud in sight.
Launchpad, knock off that infernal chatter.
Gee whiz, I was only trying to lighten the mood.
If anything, we need to lighten the plane. Feels like she's lost maneuverability with all the unexpected cargo we seem to have picked up.
No worries, Mr. McD. I've got the coordinates for Shadow Pass locked in. We'll be there lickety-split.
More like lickety-splat.
Glumgold.
Nice to see you, McDuck. Especially since you've led me right to the treasure. To whom do I owe my thanks? Your idiotic pilot? Or did you play it safe and let those two wee ones fly the plane?
You dirty cheat. Only you could sink so low.
And at 15,000 feet, no less.
Complain all you like. The lost crown of Genghis Khan will look right at home on my feathered noggin. Wouldn't you say, Scroogey?
That's what you think. You'll never beat us to Shadow Pass.
So, the crown is in Shadow Pass, eh? Thanks for telling me.
Launch pad.
Come on.
Oh, what in the shit?
A cane shouldn't be any trouble to take down. Here comes a 10 megaton finder's fee, McDuck.
I gotta get rid of the bombs. Oh, crap.
You show him, Mr. McD.
I need health.
Turn a profit on this, McDuck.
No.
Ouch.
Oh, man, this is crazy. It's an airplane battle.
This flight I've ever flown.
How dare you?
Oh no.
Scrooge.
I'm gonna die.
Hurry, you fools! He's catching up.
Got him.
You haven't seen the last of me, McDuck.
Stupid Glomgold.
We sure showed him that cheaters never cheat and winners never win, didn't we?
Try it the other way around and I couldn't agree more, Webby. Pickle me, pin feathers, there it is. Shadow Pass directly ahead. Take us down, Launchpad. Slow and steady this time.
No problemo, Mr. McD.
We're close to that treasure now. I can almost smell it.
Oh, no.
Wasn't me.
Then what was it?
That definitely wasn't me.
Whatever it is, it won't last long if it tries to get between me and the lost crown.
Uncle Scrooge, don't go.
Dinna worry, lassie. Whatever's in that cave is no match for your Uncle Scrooge. I earned my fortune by being smarter than the smarties and tougher than the toughies. If anything's in there, it'd better step aside.
But I'm scared.
Stay with Launchpad. He'll take good care of you.
Stay with Launchpad? Gee, now I'm extra scared.
Oh my. I need more health. Need more health! I'm sorry, but not more diamonds. Oh god, no! Oh Jesus. Oh god. Oh no, I missed the diamond. Oh, I'm gonna die. I should have pogoed. On the upside, I can get that diamond now. Or not. That's a tough jump, actually. I better not get a game over. It's the Yeti! I probably will have to not... Boom! I was gonna say, I probably have to jump, run under him when he does that. Gotta watch him. Oh, really? Fuck. Oh, no! I stopped to itch my ear! Fuck! Come on. Fuck you. I am going to get hurt. I'm going to get hurt, and I'm going to die. Get him, get him, get him, get him! Yeah! Oh shit! Go, go, go! I'm afraid! No! Oh, god damn it!
Ow, ow, ow.
Fuck. I hate large enemies that are impossible to dodge. There you go. F you in the butt! No. Die. Take a hit. Let's do this. He's so scary. You're making all the ice fall down. You're gonna break the mountain, bro. Yeah. Not gonna get me this time. No, sir. He's so fast. Bam!
Stop! Please stop!
Webby!
Be nice, Uncle Scrooge. That poor fuzzy lady didn't mean any harm, did you, ma'am?
Ma'am, don't be daft, lass. This monster tried to pummel me. Why, I nearly cashed my last check.
Oh, I know, ma'am. But Uncle Scrooge is really nice once you get to know him.
Webby, you understand this creature?
Of course, Uncle Scrooge. It's all in a Junior Woodchuck guidebook.
What's she saying now?
She says she's sorry if she hurt you. She's just upset because she stepped on a thorn and can't get it out.
A thorn? You don't suppose... Here's your thorn, Webigail. The lost crown of Genghis Khan.
The pretty crown. You found it.
Aye, the poor creature was standing on it. Webby, I cannot thank you enough. I hope you can find it in your heart to forgive me. Without your help, we never would have found the treasure. Oh, and thanks to you too, ma'am.
I think she likes you, Uncle Scrooge.
Yeah, that's odd. Usually it's me the ladies go gaga for.
Well, let's get home before she grows any fonder of me.
That was a little bit of a stretch there. Here's the thorn in your foot. I think they're just trying to justify some of the happenings in the past game to how they would be plausible now. Almost died there. That sucked. Alright, two stages down and we're almost 500,000. Alright.
The lost crown of Genghis Khan is mine, lads. All it took was a bit of tenacity and perseverance.
And a little kindness and patience. Right, Uncle Scrooge?
Right you are, Webby darling. Now, where's Bubba run off to?
Yeah, where is he? He was here a minute ago.
Why does no answer Bubba?
He's over there having a tea party with Webby's toys.
No. Bubba Smash!
Uh-oh, Webby. Sounds like Bubba's not getting along so good with your Quacky Patch dolls. You keep away from my dolls, mister!
Remember, kindness and patience, Webbygale. Set a good example for the lad. Well then, what treasure shall we look for next?
All right. So, we've been playing for a little over an hour now, and I've got to say that this game is a pretty good tribute so far to the original NES game, although some of the stuff is vastly different in some of the stages, and I'm not sure how I feel about that. Newer players to the franchise may not find it such a big deal, obviously, but to take it away from what I remember exactly from the Nintendo game is, I guess, to be expected, and also not necessarily all that bad, but it's kind of disappointing. We'll see. But after all, after an hour or so, this game cost about $15 on the platform I bought it on. It was on Steam. I'm pretty sure it's about the same price on the Wii U and the, I think, PS3 or Xbox. I don't remember if it's on both or either one. But it's definitely worth your time if you can get a gift copy of it or are a fan of the original series and just want to see what the remastered version looks like. Go ahead and pick it up. I think it's a pretty good investment at only $15. Plus, Capcom makes some pretty good platformers, and WayForward didn't do a very bad job at all in the development so far. The controls are nice, the remastered score is really good, very responsive, and the difficulty's not too crazy. It's not too easy, it's not too hard. So I'd have to say I recommend. And as always, if you haven't yet, follow me on Facebook and Twitter for all of my updates and things that are going on my channel. You can find past episodes and other things that are happening. And if you want to see some of my other First Fireups episodes, I'll put the link in the description for you to go check out. You can let me know what you think in the comments below. And once again, thanks for watching this episode of First Fireups, and I'll see you later.